Can you hear me? H Road, can you hear me, bro? Thanks for watching this channel, and hello everyone, this is Killer Duki. Today we are doing for the first time in the classic season of Mastery Black Phantom Deep. I'm just joking, a little drunk. You know, beer gives you 2% speed run skill, but unfortunately it is not going to be a speedrun this time. This time is going to be only a questing, and hopefully I will get the gloves mail from this run. It's the only item I need on top of the quests. So it is not going to be some specific or special run that you can run around and everything. Which I can do it, but I will not do this time because I need to loot, and I hate looting, honestly. Yeah, looting is like, just give that to healers or some caster DPS. It's their job, not mine. I mean, the tank should be a speedrunner, not a looter. Anyway, I will try to do this run with little or some information about how it works at this level, but as people have seen at the beginning on the Wailing Cavern and the Dead Mine runs, it is going to be that kind of direction until I hit level 40 or something or nearby, when I will use Blessing of Sanctuary. Then it is going to be new tactic and new strategy way of tanking. But until then, it is going to be very similar with little to no changes on the way I'm tanking. And yeah, last time I apologize for the Shadowfang keep run. When I did the informative run, for some reason my microphone was muted, so you couldn't hear me there, and I was speaking with my real life friend. So I told that people are listening to me, but it suddenly ends up I was muted, so you could hear only my friend speaking on my foreign Macedonian language. And yeah, anyway, get back to the topic. I'm just waiting for the ship right now. So the sheep, it's not coming yet. So yeah, I will try to do this run just as much as informative as you can see, to help, hopefully to help protection paladin players and fans who want to try or play protection paladin. If you disagree with my way of tanking, you're free to join some other streams and other guides to watch them. It's not limited to my videos only. I just play the way I am. I used to play this way like 15 years around or something as a protection paladin in classic. So yeah, I'm old gamer. Honestly, I began this game at 2005, and I always played main spec protection paladin, off spec retribution paladin, and alt character shadow priest. That's my specialty for the past 15 years. No changes on those stuffs. Maybe I didn't have luck to play on my shadow priest in order to show how things work in my perspective, because I don't have much time. And yeah, I got right now some time to play, but you never know in the future what happens. That's why I can't promise you anything about the Shadow Priest, but I will try to my best as possible I can to show you how things work as my perspective. But For now, I'm just focusing on the protection paladin. Many people just complain, I mean, not many, but some people complain that on my videos I just don't explain stuff and everything, but that's why I'm trying. I will try to. I know I will be focused in the game, so you will sometimes see me be quiet when I try to focus in the dungeon run, but I will try to speak as much as I can. You know, I mean, everyone who played the game and have a passion in the game, you can sense that this player is focused in the things he do, if he want to do like perfect way. Of course, mistakes happen, and the best way for everyone. But if you see someone focused and silent when he's trying to do some stuff, that means he's full focused and he's trying not to do mistakes. And you can notice that on the other streamers either, doesn't matter. Oh, I got someone, nice. Thank you guys, I will write this now. You know, I like the way they, no, maybe not that much about the summon, but yeah, I like the way the changes was made in this classic season of mastery. Honestly, I think this is the biggest improvement in this game. As a classic, you don't have much differences, so they kept the same game. Yeah, well, honestly, these guys wants to rush a little bit. I know this game is too old and everyone wants to rush to do things much faster and easier, but it's good when you do the quests just to focus on doing the quest. I mean, yeah, when you focus on doing the quest, you just want things done. These are, you can see, this is the demon, that's why I use it, exorcism. And I like when they disarm me, because I can grant and increase my skill for the weapon, so I don't make some dodges and parries and miss when I swing with my melee weapon. Sure. I will share the quests right now. Okay. Bum bum. That's it. Wow, on first shot. Got my Pauline quest, so I can do it. Disarm. I hate it, but at the same time I like it, because I can skill my disarm skill right now. Brain. I hate to loot, but yeah, it's wasting my time so much. Hordy, oh no, it's not Hordy. I thought it was, but it's not. Oops. The healer is not healing me for some reason, I don't know why. Had to take over, but okay. I thought he was healer, because on my last Shadowfang Keeper run, which you can't find it on the YouTube, he was a healer. But it's on my Twitch. You know, on the Twitch, when I don't do informative run in my Twitch, I'm using music. That's why I'm not able to upload those videos, because censorship. I hate this fascism, but anyway, we have to deal with that and live with that. Censorship is the worst thing ever can happen to anyone as a free speech in the internet. So yeah, everyone should be against that. it's a kind of fascism when, or dictatorship, where they dictate what you are allowed or not allowed to speak or anything. Don't remember everything in this game, and this guy is asking me stuff, so I can't say if he's inside or not. So yeah, it seems two group. Doesn't matter, it's easy for me to do the quest, the brain quest outside, because yeah, they are low level for me, so I can do it outside if need. As you see, those are demons, and exorcism is better option. And you don't need on two mobs, you don't even need consecration, because as you see, exorcism is doing a lot of threat. And this warrior, maybe you didn't notice, but you can turn back the video, he did taunt. It can be seen on a very single second. So yeah, doesn't matter. This type of people exist always. They just troll because you're a paladin tank and he's taunting. I don't know why. Maybe he's doing that for as a purpose. Maybe he's doing that to make a rage. I'm not so sure, but it's his problem, not mine. I like that I'm looting those. Let me sharp my weapon. Oh, Hellstone, wow, nice, thank you. Alright, let me use the food buff. So I can get some extra stamina. Not that I don't need, I need, but everything is good. These are not giving me some quests, so it's cool to little run a bit. Murlocs, go, get some experience, and yeah, bum bum bum. No corruptor, okay. That's nice. I will go die. Nope. Probably. But it's a good time to use my health song and my potion. I like to use potions because I'm helping the group that way when they are not focused. And I'm not so sure why it is. I know he's a retribution paladin healing me at this type of level, it's fine, but later on the high level I will never accept off-spec healers like from Sunken Temple and so on. Yeah, there is no point to accept them there. I know this is classic and it's very easy, but no, it's not effective, and it makes problems with slowing down the run and everything, so it's not good that to have a off-spec healer. Like, you should be a main spec. I know you are going to complain the hybrids, blah blah blah, and so on, but hybrids still have main specs. This guy is off-spec, which is making a huge difference as a main spec. Protection paladin, you can tank easy. You can still tank as a retribution paladin, but it's going to be problem. It's going to make a problem with damage taken. So yeah, off spec is off spec. Main spec is main spec. Should respect that. But yeah, I know many people don't do that. So it's expected someone to do the way they are. Anyway, if you you have, guys, some questions, feel free to ask me on my YouTube channel. Please subscribe on the channel, and yeah, the more you help me out with subscription, the more I will be able to show you my 15 years of tanking as a protection paladin experience. Of course, if I get enough if I get enough people who support me, I will be doing even raids, because you know, time is money, and in order to do raids and waste my time on this game so much, I will need some donations. But if I don't have the donation, I will play as much as I can. Not because I don't have money, I have the money, but I need time, and if I don't work today, I'm losing money. That's why I said, if I don't get donation, I will have to work and then play when I'm free. Otherwise, I will, if I get donations, I will be full-time free for the specific amount, just to do more playing for you guys and get in the raids and show you my experience as this type of streaming, so you can see every single bit of the game. I told them to do those mobs in order to get the brainstem quest done. I like there is a warlock in the group. Okay, they asked bullets for some reason, but doesn't matter, we'll still be doing. I need to rebuff people. Okay, I got the aggro now, it's going to be cool. You know, the way you coordinate when you have to buff the people is when you see your own. For example, I'm using Blasting Wisdom right now, it's the best on this level until I get Sanctuary. So when I see my buff is about to disappear, like 50 seconds or something, I just know that I have to rebuff the whole group. That's why, you see, I'm buffing myself and then the rest of the group with Salvation, which is mandatory to use Salvation on the damage dealers, regardless of how good or bad DPS they are. Otherwise, they are going to waste your mana and everything. It is 30% more DPS for them and less mana using for yourself. That's why a blessing of salvation for the damage dealers. Because I have another paladin in the group, I gave him blessing of salvation. Yeah. But he is going to do whatever the group need, and to secure myself that I'm not going to waiting for him to rebuff me, because you know there are so many slackers around in the game. I just buffed myself with my mandatory buff Wisdom. So whether he buffed me with Wisdom or not doesn't matter. I want to make sure that I have it from myself. If he's a slacker, I don't care. Same as 40 plus level when there is a sanctuary buff, I want to make myself with sanctuary and the group with salvation, no matter what. It was just wasted wordless blessing of freedom he gave me, but yeah, as he didn't buff me anything else, it's still good. Freedom, doesn't matter. I have my own, but it depends. You need that only if you see the group is struggling, but when the mobs are on you, there is no point to give me blessing of freedom. Like, literally no point. I just stun that mob with, because I seen him run toward the group and I auto attack one or two times. I will get the aggro because the holy damage have increased the threat, and yeah, and I have nice weapon. That's why I am doing semi roleplay adventure. Maybe you noticed, maybe not. I'm spamming the chats and everything, whoever is on my server. I play semi roleplay when I do Deadmine until I get all the tanking gear from Deadmine that I need. I don't go for the next level dungeon, not because I can't, because I want to play that way and have the best possible gear from the dungeons before I get to the next one. Just for fun, you know. Now I use it myself, blessing of freedom, because this boss is a little weird from far away. He's doing some nasty chain lights. Yeah, I will buff the group with salvation because the boss. I have already so much aggro on the boss, as you can see my threat meter, if it is correct. Yeah. There is no more nagas. Let's go. Let's. Congratulations for the hunter. I like and I enjoy when people get gear, but as long as they play fair and don't screw up on the rolls and ninjas and everything, unless it is a reserve for them something, they should not do it. Told them to clean these nagas, just to complete this quest with corrupt brain steam. It's much better to complete something and then to run for another time here and waste so much time for nothing. Not that I can't do that, I can, but why not everyone do it? That's a nice pooling, but he's a little overrating that. Okay, that's why you have a protection paladin with AoE. You know, it's fine to AoE and everything as a protection paladin, but you know, people are thinking like you can't lose aggro, but anytime you can lose aggro because you're not hitting that hard on the other targets. So you either have to swap all the time, or you need some spell damage to have strong AoE DPS. But you know, people don't realize how it works and everything. Doesn't matter. Their issue, if they die, they die. It's their own fault. They are over aggroing stuff. Let's see if there are some mobs here either. Yeah, seems so. Let's do it. Do it. actually nice spirit. There is no strength. Frost resistance is good. It's about the same. Doesn't matter. It's not best. It's not bad. It's like equal with some minor difference, which makes no difference. So I will keep the one that I'm using. I need two more corrupted brains in to show what else. Ah, I got screwed up. When I was about to run there and loot, I got frozen. Like now. This hunter is so lucky, so many mobs drops for him, I mean leather items drops for him. As you see, I don't spam much of my spells, just Seal and Judgment of Righteousness. That's the way of how Paladin tanks, so I'm drinking my beer. Meanwhile, it depends on the action. I'm using like consecration when it needs like one or two time maximum. Explain it to him. He's doing perfect job on that stuff because I never noticed anyone else who is ice pulling to do such a nice job dragging the mobs next to me and then drop his aggro in order for me to get that. It's speeding the run and he's cooperative, which is perfect addition. Like I like, it's not that I'm supposed to say, I like when the people cooperate and are enough skilled to know when to drop or not, so they don't sacrifice anyone by doing that. If you're a skilled puller. It's a hunter job mainly, but unfortunately, not many hunters doing that. Majority of the hunters don't know how to do that. They have the perfect skills for that, but they're not. Anyway. Alright. It's a warlock doing this, which is a little funny, but yeah, it's nice. I need two more brains, and the hunter needs one more, and the warlock two more. Only the healer didn't loot any for some reason, I don't know why. Okay, this is an easy run, so. As you can see, a judgment with the when I pull mob, random mob, I use Judgment of Righteousness and I don't have to use anything else than that on the single target mob because the mob is going to die anyway. If you go with Judgment of Crusade straight with that mob and if the mob die fast, it is wasted mana, honestly. waste of mana, because the mob is going to die fast and you are doing inefficient. Whoa, why is he fearing? Okay, doesn't matter. His reason. Like, if the mob die fast, you don't have to use Judgment of Crusade. If the mob dies slow, then you're like a boss. Yeah, I'm not so sure why he has, but yeah, probably he overlooked him. I need two more of those. Hopefully I will get them. Yeah, disarm, disarm, disarm. At least I got some nice kills, so yeah. Easy peasy, Sirenas. See a witch. A witch. Witch. I like these horror movies and mythology movies. There are witch and everything, but unfortunately, the history says that the real people who was called witch was some people who was using alternative medicine in order to help people, because even in that type of period in the history, the doctors didn't want competition in order to make profit. They was just proclaiming the alternative medicine people who was unfortunately the main victims was gypsies. And I was the main victims of those narrative as a witch, because they was using some alternative healing sources, like using nature goods and stuff in order to heal people. But yeah, competition is crazy, you know. It can destroy many lives. Even rich people are brutal sometime when it is about the competition in question. And yeah, that's how life is. I need to get some extra mana so I can exorcism that mob. No. Enough. One exorcism will keep him up. One more brain, please. One more brain, and then I'm doing the quest completing. It's not that long dungeon, I'm just making it longer because I want to complete the quest. Otherwise it's much much faster than this. I wouldn't waste time on inside the water. I'm doing this for myself and of course if people either want, which is normal. Ah, he got it, my last. Come on. Hope I will get one more chance for that. Disarm, disarm, but I think I got the skill. 107 out of 140, almost there. Moorlogs, they are the best for ass pulling. The most famous Moorlogs for ass pulling. 50 kill leeches, it's a healer job then. It's not mana leeching, so it's no problem. Ooh, he's doing the damage to the group. I have to pull it on myself. There is no loot from those mobs, but from the boss. I hope the gloves drop right now and I win it. That way I can continue, get some quests, hit the level and go for the next journey, a dungeon journeys. They hit a little hard with the spells, it seems. Yeah, it seems so. So I'll have to leave the healer with some mana. I will heal myself. That interrupted the bubble before it ends, the heal, so I can give some few more seconds to healer to regen some mana. Time for rebuffing. Buffs are done, I will use some food buff. No winner rate for the healer, otherwise it would have been amazing combo, sharpening my weapons for some extra threat and DPS and threat. It's a boss time. Wow, I think they are reading my mind. I was about to say kill boss, but they did it. I mean, kill mobs, sorry. But since they read my mind and did it exactly on the time when they need to. Go, go, gloves! Go, go, gloves! Let me win them. Scheiße, as the German says. I'm not German, but yeah. Why not on my first time, just for luck? Let's go, let's do it. Let me get some buff. I don't need those. I will grit. I know it's a minor upgrade, but I will let the other paladin get it. Yeah. No gloves. Let's do it. I completed Twilight Pendant, another crazy thing to loot. Yeah, those are little harder than these brains. But I will do the brains for the other guy. The healer needs them. And they want the chest, of course. I will pass them. It's not a problem to do the chest. If it's not mandatory, it doesn't give some special item, maybe, but it's very rare. I'm a little hungry and I'm drinking beer right now, so it's going to pass. It's going to be a little awkward run, because, you know, when stomach is speaking, you're not speaking. So after this one, I will take off and we'll do tomorrow another run for Black Phantom Deep for the gloves, and probably I will get them, hopefully. I used my healing potion because I noticed I'm not getting any heals from the healer. It's an instinct in case. It's not a big potion, but still, you know, everything is extra. Well, he have another so much aggro in order to focus myself on this mob, because Exorcism and Judgment of Righteousness is too much aggro already. I think it there was a boss which varied from spot to spot, but I'm not so sure if he spawned or not. Okay, that guy have so much aggro. I will focus on this with no ordinary hits. You know, you want to judgment one target and then to focus DPS sync and swap target on the other target. I think here is going to be... Okay, judgment and exorcism on the other mob was more than enough, so I'm focused on this mob. The boss is here. The boss is here. Good job. The same story I did to the demon. If it was a normal mob, I would judge and swap all the time, because much more aggro they need. And there is no exorcism for the more normal mob. Hey, Hroth, what's the crying? Oh, for the item, yeah, mage. Doesn't matter, next run. It's just wasting time, I know, but yeah. There will be always another chance. It will slow things down, but yeah. And as I said, my time is limited, so have to deal with that, and I'm going to hit the level. I just read your message, Crowd, right now, because I'm not always on the chat. I mean, I can see from OBS the chat, but I'm not really always reading, because I want to focus in the run right now. And Dingarini got some extra armor, nice. Gracias. Thank you. I get a little boring when I have to always say thank you for leveling up some easy levels, at least. Like, it's cool, you just have tradition by doing that, but it's not a big deal today, at least. Let me bump the people, because it's about to disappear my blessing, and I know that I have to rebuff everyone in the group. That way nobody is wasting time, and since I buff myself first with Blessing of Wisdom. I still have some mana regeneration, which mean I will regenerate some mana at least to buff others and everything, so I don't waste time with the group, which is not good idea to waste people time. Don't do that. That's my, if you see Paladin wasting time drinking all the time mana, no, not good, kick him. Like, it depends, sometime can happen, I never say no, not always. If you see Paladin all, every single pool, every single group, wasting mana, drinking, because he wasted so much mana on consecration, bam, 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 which is really stupid idea. Because you don't want to waste your mana on consecration, especially on two targets or one target, because consecration is not the best threat ability. It is good threat ability, but not the best. It is nice for AoE, but like one or two times to do it, it's cool, no more than that. Otherwise, it's wasting mana for nothing. If people over aggro you, it's out. It's over aggro. Either give them salvation, which most of the protection paladins are doing this mistake by not giving the group salvation, especially on the rogues and the hunters. And then everything gets screwed up because of them. So, yeah. You want to stay on your principles, salvation on the group, in order to waste less 30% mana and the people can do 30% more damage thanks to reduced aggro. Prove me that I'm wrong. Oh, someone complete. How did he complete? Oh, maybe from some previous run. Maybe. Yeah. I'm wondering how he have completed when it's only few mobs we killed. But it's good. Less people. More pendants for me. So yeah, higher chance to get it. Hey, easy mobs. In the private servers, this spot in this place is doom. You're going to die. But here, yeah. You see, it's so easy. I mean, I like when the private servers, for instance, is doing the more HP, higher HP on the mobs and bosses, which is totally fine. But the problem with the private servers is when they increase the damage done by the mobs and the boss by 100 or something percent, I don't know, don't get me correct on this, and this is causing a problem to some classes because the damage income is not the same as the health. When there is a health, the fight duration. The fight duration just get longer, which is about the same. It makes no difference between the classes and everything and specs. But when they increase the damage done by the mobs and the boss, then it is making big difference between the warriors and the paladin tanks, because the warriors are going to get much bigger benefits because of the defense stance, 10% reduction of the overall damage, while paladin damage taken is reduced by shields absorbed from shields absorbed speciality, I mean shield specialization which is flat damage reduction instead of. Oh, why he's doing that? It's just terrible. Don't do that. Okay, ice pullers, ninja pullers, whatever. They should not do that. It's bad, it's rude. You want your tank to do that, not the mobs. And what happened now? The whole group you're going to pull. It's disaster, I mean. Maybe they did want to do that, but it's very bad to do that. Lucky they got some skills. So we can AoE. When you hide at the wall, they are not going to hit you from far away. That's why I said some skills, because you need to use brain and logic instead of motion and whatever. It's not one button game. We need to think how to do stuff. That's why I told everyone to just come, so we hide at the corner, and that way we drag them toward me and they weigh them down. But why they are still killing people? This dungeon is so much bugged, as you can see. To die, no idea. Okay, for the boss, just Judgment of Crusade and Seal of Righteousness. Enjoy your beer one consecration just for fun to have some burst of threat on the beginning. And yeah, as you see, I will do nothing until the boss die, just auto attack and Seal of Righteousness. That's it. I'm drinking my beer right now. Okay, let's go. As you see, that's how you need to do the threat. I like that there is a warlock in the group, otherwise this place is going to be so annoying. And I understand the people why they are getting annoying. Frozen can't jump. You know, when even when people are wrong, you need still to smile, not because it's funny, it's not funny, but you have to adapt to the situation. Otherwise, you have some problems with the people. Like, how should you explain that you get freezing yourself, and because of the aggro, the mob is on you. So, you can read the chat. So, anyway, people are people. It's always like that. Doesn't matter. If everything was perfect, it would have been boring in this world. Wow, I got a chance to pull so many mobs, which is amazing. I did some 2 times consecration, but I will do it one more time because the healer don't have much mana and they need to burst some more DPS, not because it is good or bad, it doesn't matter, the aggro is mine, but I will have to burst because I will die. Healer don't have enough mana to survive. And yeah, it's going to be nasty and hurt. I need to heal myself, the healer is without mana. One more consecration because too much heals. While I pen them. Thank you. Go. Five more. I'll die. No. Instinct. I will have to apologize because it was basically my bad for pulling that much mobs without mana. So yeah, that is calling responsibility, which I have to say sorry, at least. Not that I can do anything about it, but yeah, it happens. Hey, everything is buffed. I have food buff and everything. Let's go. I don't have mana, but I think I have to swap often the targets all the time. That is how it should supposed to be when you don't have mana. And once you get it, thanks to Blessing of Wisdom, which is the main reason why you need Blessing of Wisdom, is to regenerate some mana. And you see, until I spend on one consecration, I got enough mana for the second, and it's more than enough to keep those mobs on me right now, currently. Of course, it can happen some mob to run to the group, and then you swap to that mob and try to get the aggro from that mob. Now they are running in fear, so it's not aggro. Twilight Pendant, 6 out of 10, but I will not do it. I think I will need one more run. Anyway, I'm still chasing the gloves, which is going to be perfectly fine. Okay, there is one more pulled. I see he targets someone else, not me. He's doing some buffs or anything. Okay, all the mobs are on killer duty, which is good, and it's supposed to be like that. Have to swap targets all the time in order to keep decent aggro without wasting my mana or consecration. But those mobs are hitting me with some flame shock, which is hurting. Doesn't matter if he pull. It's a classic, it's not private servers with gazillions HP and gazillions DPS. It's classic. Thank you for the frost pendant. Twilight pendant, sorry. Okay. Mobs will come because I hide behind the wall, which is supposed to be like that, and someone else complete the quest already, which is perfect and amazing. More chances for me to finish the quest. Okay, need to run away, but I got dazed. That's why I want to get defense cap in the future. Not because he can't do anything or can't survive, but because I don't want to get dazed. Eight out of ten. Two more pendants. Twilight pendant. One more, and I'm going to complete the quest. Please, one more, please. Begging you. Put yourself Halloween, baby. I don't know how to sing, but screw it up. See, you need to hide behind the wall, and those mobs will come and hit their asses inside the consecration. And poof, critical strike. One twilight pendant for me, please. Just one. So I don't have to waste my time doing the quests next time. And I can speed up the runs, but it's a last chance, it seems. They got it. I need one more to drop for me, and that's it. Everyone got it. Yeah, as far as I can see, it's like that. So, go. Give it to me. Thank you. Well done. Completed all the quests. Next run, it is going to be fast run, of course, with music and everything, blah, blah, blah. So it is going to do it. I will go to do the next time runs only for the gloves, because I don't need anything else from here. So as long as I chase the gloves, that's it. Wow, I got slit by the boss in order for him to run toward the group. Wow, that's fantastic. And then he ran back to me, maybe not, I will see. I will blessing or protection him, and now he's going to do what? Nothing. Swap aggro me. It's a unresistible taunt. Intellect and spirit. It's extremely good. Good. Buff. I mean, it's a bit. Oh, I need to get the quest done. Thank you for reminding me. Questy. One by one. Boom. I can get all of them, but let's not sacrifice and risk right now. So I guess everything is completed. Well, then next run it will be just hands drop. That's it. It is going to be much, 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 much faster, and I won't have to kill all the mobs around the water and waste my time. Time is money, friend, as the goblins say, and I will tell you why. Because as much time you waste on stuff that you don't profit, you're losing money. Even when you see streamers around, okay? It's perfectly fine to stream, but you need to know streamers do the streams to get money and profit from the donation. And I'm not going to lie, because I don't want to lie people, that's normal, and I'm doing the same for the same goal, hopefully, because time is money, as I said, as the goblin said in the Booty Bay, you can hear that. Nobody will waste his precious time in some game if he don't have some type of interest by playing that game. Of course, we can all play for fun, but doesn't mean that I will give some effort to stream, put my time to waste here and everything for nothing. But as you, I'm not so sure if so many guys are aware about this. When people subscribe actually to YouTube channel, even if you don't pay and if you have enough subscriptions, you still get money from people watching you on the YouTube. So even if you don't have money to pay, at least subscribe to YouTube and watch the channel. It still benefits thanks to the advertisement and how the YouTube policy is. It's not big money, but still it's helping out promoting the streams and everything. So it's a win-win. You win getting free streams and everything without paying any money, and the streamer is getting money from nothing, like nobody's donating, but he still get money from YouTube. I don't know how, why, but yeah, whatever. Okay, let's get back to the game. Enough from my own stupid advertising. I'm just joking. Oh, no, yeah. Anyway, this is a trash stream. It's not fun until you get to the raid. In the raid, it will be so fun to see how things go. Judgment of Righteousness, trade 200 threats, and then continuing with your swings, and everyone else is like nowhere near to you. You don't need anything else thanks to Salvation and Righteous Fury. It's done. Days, I'm getting days, I hate days. Let's pull it back so people don't ask pull those turtles. I will have to get one, but yeah, Judgment of Righteousness. It's more than enough as long people don't hit it. Let's kill the boss. Nope, stun, he's immune on stun, I think. No, he's not. Let's see if the other paladin stun him. Eh, he will die. Anyway, I don't have the debuff for resistance, but yeah. Not a big deal. Congratulations for leather, but I don't think anyone needs. Doesn't matter. think it is going to be.
Mm-hmm.
I don't need the frost resistance. As long as he poured me to darkness, staying. I don't have much time to play anymore for tonight, but see you tomorrow on my Twitch channel, Killer Dookie, with some music. And of course, I'm focused on YouTube, not on Twitch. I want to full focus on the YouTube and post this type of informative runs for you. And yeah, thank you for watching, and have a nice day. Oh, back to the music, Twitch. You will hear my music right now, so it's cool.